अंदर हमें देखने को मिलती है। इसमें हम ये मान के चलते हैं कि वाकई में इस संसार को क्रिएट करने वाला कोई एक गॉड है और उस गॉड का नाम अल्लाह है, तो उस अल्लाह ने इस संसार को कितने दिनों में क्रिएट किया, इसके बारे में कुरान पे अलग अलग जगह पे रेफरेंसेस आती हैं। यही जो सातवां चैप्टर है, इसकी अगर आप 54वीं आयत देखें, 54th वर्स अगर आप देखते हैं, तो उसमें ये क्लियरली बताया गया है कि अल्लाह ने 6 दिनों में धरती और हेवन को बनाया। यहाँ पे जो ट्रांसलेशन है अहमद रजा खान की, इनडीड योर लॉर्ड इज अल्लाह हु क्रिएटेड द हेवंस एंड द अर्थ इन 6 डेज, इतना हम एक्सेप्ट कर लेते हैं। अब इसी की हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन चेक करते हैं, ये है फारूक खान और अहमद के द्वारा। निस्संदेह तुम्हारा रब वही अल्लाह है जिसने आकाशों और धरती को 6 दिनों में पैदा किया। तो इंग्लिश में भी सेम है, हिंदी में भी सेम है। अब हम चलते हैं चैप्टर नंबर 41 पे, जो 41वीं सूरह है कुरान की, उसकी 9वीं से लेके 12वीं आयत। ये जो चार आयतें हैं, ये भी धरती और आकाश के बनाने के बारे में बात करती हैं। तो पहले इंग्लिश ट्रांसलेशन देखते हैं, अहमद रजा खान की ट्रांसलेशन है ये। से वॉट यू डिसबिलीव इन हिम हु क्रिएटेड द अर्थ इन 2 डेज एंड यू अपॉइंट इक्वल्स टू हिम, ही इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ द क्रिएशन। अगली आयत, एंड इन इट ही प्लेस माउंटेन्स एज एंकर्स फ्रॉम अबव इट एंड ब्लेसिंग्स इन इट एंड अपॉइंटेड द सस्टेनेंस फॉर दोज हु ड्वेल इन इट, ऑल दिस इन 4 डेज, अ प्रॉपर आंसर टू दोज हु क्वेश्चन। फिर 11वीं आयत आती है, हम 12वीं पे चलते हैं। ही देन एस्टैब्लिश्ड देम इनटू 7 हेवंस इन 2 डेज। तो जो पूरा प्रोसेस है 2 दिन प्लस 4 दिन प्लस 2 दिन 8 दिन का है, जबकि पहले वो कह रहे हैं कि 6 दिन में क्रिएशन होता है। इसी की हिंदी ट्रांसलेशन देखिए, कहो क्या तुम उसका इनकार करते हो जिसने धरती को 2 दिनों में पैदा किया और तुम उसके समकक्ष ठहराते हो, वह तो सारे संसार का रब है और उसने उसमें उसके ऊपर से पहाड़ जमाए और उसमें बरकत रखी और उसमें उसकी खुराकों को ठीक अंदाजे से रखा। मांग करने वालों के लिए समान रूप से यह सब 4 दिन में हुआ। तो 2 दिन पहले हो गए थे, 4 दिन अब हो गए, 6 हो जाते हैं। फिर उसने आकाश की ओर रुख किया जबकि वह मात्र धुआं था, और उसने उससे और धरती से कहा, आओ, स्वेच्छा के साथ या अनिच्छा के साथ? उन्होंने कहा, हम स्वेच्छा के साथ आए। फिर 2 दिनों में उनको अर्थात 7 आकाशों को बनाकर पूरा किया और प्रत्येक आकाश में उससे संबंधित आदेश की प्रकाशना कर दी, और दुनिया के आकाश को हमने दीपों से जलाया और सुरक्षित करने के उद्देश्य से यह अत्यंत प्रभुत्वशाली सर्वज्ञ का ठहराया हुआ है। तो फिर से 2 प्लस 4 प्लस 2, 8 दिन में क्रिएशन।
The Quran says the heavens and the earth were created in 6 days. When Surah Fussilat it says 8 days. Isn't there a contradiction and also contradiction with the Big Bang theory? I do agree with you, brother. The Quran says in several places that the heavens and the earth were created in 6 days. In several places. Araf chapter 7 verse number 54. In Surah Yunus chapter 10 verse number 3. In Surah Hud chapter 11 verse number 7. In Surah Furqan chapter 25 verse number 59. In Surah Sajdah chapter 32 verse number 4. In Surah Hadid, chapter 57, verse number 4. In several places, the Quran says the heavens and the earth were created in 6 days. It's not the earthly days, it is ayams, very long periods, which scientists have got no objection to. And I also agree with you that the Quran does speak about the creation of the heavens and the earth in Surah Fussilat. The verse you are referring to, brother, is verses 9 to 12, which says that. Do you not believe in the one who has created the earth in 2 days? And do you join equals with him? Do you join partners with him who is the Lord of the worlds? Verse number 10 says, he has set on the earth mountains standing firm and given due nourishment on the earth in 4 days. Verse number 11 says, moreover, in his design he comprehended the sky when it was smoke, and he said to it and the earth, come ye together willingly or unwillingly? And they said, we come together in willing obedience. This he did in 2 days. So if you read it just without thinking, 2 plus 4 plus 2 is 8 days. Quran gives the answer in the starting of the verse, that it says that all those who will take out this fault, they are equal to those people who will join partners to God. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that there will be people who will take out fault in the Quran in this verse. They will be the mushriks. And today, this verse is commonly used by the Christian missionaries against the Muslims. If you go around, I've been traveling the world, this question was posed to me even there. The Christian missionaries, they pose this question. Quran says, it predicts that people will ask about this question, and these people will be those who are associate partners with God. Let's analyze. The first two verses, that is Surah Fusilat, chapter 41, verse 9 and 10, says that the earth was created in 2 days, and then mountains were set on it, and nourishment was given in due proportion in 4 days. So it says, 2 days the earth was formed, mountains were set on it afterwards, in 4 days, total comes to 6 days. Then verse number 11 starts with the Arabic word summa. Now the Arabic word summa can be translated in 3 different ways. One is then, one is moreover, and the other is simultaneously. I do know that many translations have translated the Arabic word summa as then. If you translate summa as then there is a contradiction. It says then the heavens were made in 2 days. That means 2 plus 4 plus 2 is equal to 8 days. But the exact translation should be, summa should be translated as moreover or simultaneously. And Abdullah Yusuf Ali, alhamdulillah, in this place has translated summa correctly as moreover. So if you translate summa as moreover or simultaneously, it will mean that when the earth and the mountains were created in 6 days, simultaneously the heavens were created in 2 days. For example, suppose a builder, he gives in his brochure that I have constructed a 10-story building along with its surrounding and compound wall in 6 months. When a person wants to buy a flat in that building, he goes to the builder and he asks for more detail. So the builder says, it took me 2 months to make the basement of the building and another 4 months to make the 10-story. And while I was building the basement and the story, I simultaneously built the compound wall and the surrounding in 2 months. It's possible. So then he's not contradicting. Total comes to, yes, 6 months. So similarly, when Surah Fusilat chapter 41, verse number 9 to 12, it says that while the earth was created along with the mountain in 6 days, simultaneously the heavens was created in 2 days. There's no contradiction. And similarly, if you take then, it contradicts with science, because earth was created first, then were created the mountains. It's contradicting. Similarly, Quran speaks in Surah Baqarah, chapter 2, verse 29, that Allah made the earth, summa the heavens. But unfortunately here, Abdullah Yusuf Ali has translated summa wrongly as then. In verse 29 of Surah Baqarah, chapter 2, he translates summa as then. Allah created the earth and then the heaven. Then there's a contradiction. Even here, summa should be translated as moreover or simultaneously. If it's translated simultaneously, then it's not a contradiction, because the Big Bang theory tells us that the earth and the heavens were created simultaneously. No wonder in the Quran, the Quran says in many places, we created the heaven and the earth. In other places it says, we created the earth and the heavens. Giving evidence to the verse of the Quran of Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter 21, verse number 30, it says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتْ رَتْقًا فَتَقْنَاهُمَا. That do not the unbelievers see that the heavens and the earth were joined together and we clove them asunder.